Hi guys, and welcome to this video tutorial where we'll see how to make this simple interface with just one knob. User interface, or UI for short, in the digital era we live is everywhere, from smartphones, computer operating systems, or applications of any kind, games, software, to even subway touchscreen automatic ticket sales, and in modern vehicles, which have a touchscreen to control various actions for the vehicle through a monitor. User interface, of course, exists in a form of either displaying information, for example, displaying a temperature control, or receiving information from the user, usually with some buttons which then the software turns it into actions. User interface design, also known as GUI, which stands for graphical user interface, is the visual design interaction part of basically everything you see in front of your eyes when opening a software or a device with a digital screen, so it can interact by pressing various buttons by the user, or commander if you like, which then goes straight into the software and turn it into an action of all kinds. With digital programming in its heart, the UI graphics are just there to give commands with a good visual, most of the times attractive and appealing way, but not in all cases. Sometimes it's plain simple pixels, but they do the job. GUI might consist of many elements like buttons, knobs, faders, display screens, icons, but also beautiful backgrounds. Okay. Enough with the theory. Here we will be using Photoshop CC 2017 to make this interface, which is mostly targeted towards the audio industry. So grab a coffee or whatever else you feel like and let's jump right into it. Alright guys, here we are, and we'll start by making a new canvas with this dimension here, and we'll take the rectangular shape tool, which is below that arrow you hold on the menu, with these settings here: mode on shape, fill black, stroke nothing, and we start by making, we imagine our shape. Now, because it's black, you can't see it, but we'll double click here on the right side of the text and it will bring up the blending options. We will add a gradient overlay. We'll reset to default and click on the gradient to make a new gradient. We'll make it kind of dark gray with just a little hint of blue. We'll just click on the marks below the gradient, we move them, we create new ones by clicking there, and you have to follow a bit here. We moved the point of that to make it sharp, we added a new point there, we move the point inwards, click on the middle again to make a new, make it a little darker, and then this gradient, you don't have to get the exact same results. This is just an example. So we made it sharp down there and we leave it like this at this point. We enable dithering. Go to color overlay now. We'll add a black color on multiply mode and just make it a tiny bit darker, with opacity on there. So now, I will name this the base. We'll go to layer, just to duplicate it. Layer, new layer via copy. So we have an exact same copy above the other, and we will remove this color overlay now, just to be a little brighter. You'll see why. We'll go on the pen tool and hold control and click on those points there and hold control again and move them on the left side, to make the handles. So this is something like handle design, or just for design's sake. And we'll add a drop shadow with these settings here, just to distinguish it a little bit more. And right now you need to have Photoshop CC 2015 and above to click that plus icon on the gradient overlay, and it makes a copy. We'll use a black and white on color dodge mode just to give a little bit shine on the top side. Now with Control and J, or Command and J on Macintosh, we duplicate that, and holding Shift and moving it to the other side. I will name this the right. So now I will shift and click all of them, put them on the group. You'll see why. We'll center this. So we have now all of them grouped, and we go to the move tool, selecting all and clicking the horizontal and vertical alignment tools, and now it's on dead center. This is very helpful for symmetric designs and so on. Now give a little bit attention, because this one will be a little difficult for beginners. We double click on the blending options there, we add a bevel and emboss, we reset to default, and using these settings here, we'll create a little fake illusion of depth. You'll see how later on. And I will just duplicate that layer with the bevel and emboss. Now, I'm removing the fill opacity. This layer will be on top of the other hand. I will remove the bevel and emboss, so the bottom one can be shown. And go to the other gradient. Click on the gradient. We'll add on the top side now a little mark. And we'll remove the opacity. So now if you see on the middle of the handle, something like depth, tweaking a little bit the settings. Compare the right one with the left one, it's much more 3D like. So if you follow along with these settings, you can create two. If you need, you can go backwards in the video and replay it to really understand it. So basically, we duplicate the handle with Control J. Right now, I will right click and copy the layer style of this and paste it on the other one, because I want it similar. So, but first, we have to copy the layer style with the bevel and emboss from the right handle and put it on the bottom layer of the handle, on the bottom copy of the layer of the left handle. I know this looks crazy, but here's the result. It's the most difficult thing we'll see in this video. And let's move on. Just tweaking a little bit. I think I will make the background a little bluer. So we added a new copy of a color overlay. We add the color, a little bit of color on top. And I'm making it darker a bit, just for a better contrast with the handles. Making the top of the handles a little brighter. Just looks nicer this way. I'm copying the layer style of the highlight handle, as we call it. And now you'll have to really have it on big size screen to see here, but I will add a little dirty texture in small size and very, very low opacity, just for a little dirty touch, a little analog feel if you like in audio. Again, copying the style, pasting it. Now it has dirt. And I'm going to the pattern overlay, and with the move tool, I move the pattern. I will add on the base a little dirt too, but I need to go to the gradient and remove a little bit of the opacity first. And with the move tool, we can move the pattern anywhere we like. So now all of it is a little bit dirty. This is just a taste. If you like, you can do it very clean. Real device has a little bit of texture in it, even a tiny bit. We'll take the ellipse from the shapes. These settings as before on shape and fill mode with black, no stroke. And by holding shift, we will create a perfect circle, put it in the middle. Now we take the move tool, we go select all, center it again, because we know that our design is on center. That's why this is helpful. Now we double click here and start creating the knob. You can follow along here with these settings. We will create the place that the knob lives inside, something like an emboss here. It's actually inverted bevel. Okay, so this is the outer part, I just copied it. I will make the inner here, double clicking in there, and we'll make some new settings. Just to add some details, outer detail or inner. And you can experiment your own. This is just for inspiration. You can do it with many ways and many different results. So on the inner part, I put a gradient overlay. Just to distinguish a little bit, the lighting is coming from above. I'm tweaking a little bit the settings here. Brighter highlight. Less depth. Alright, I think this is good. And now we will make the outer ring, which is something like LED light. I just copied the circle, the inner circle. I am removing the fill but putting a stroke. With like 7 pixels width, with Control T, I scaled it a little bit inwards. And now removing the fill opacity and going to add a little gradient here. We will colorize it with a little fade also. And actually this one is the part which doesn't have light. This is the part where when it's off, you will see in a little bit. Just scaling it a little bit. I'm duplicating this part now, and this will be the lighted part, the top as I call it here. I will add a color overlay, or actually go into the gradient and make it blue LED. I will add outer glow with these settings here. Sorry for going so fast. I will put this now into a group. I just dragged it into the group into the folder icon. I will add a layer mask here. And I'll take the soft eraser and onto the mask with white color on my brush. I just erased a little bit of the bottom part. Sorry, this is getting too complicated, but now inside that group, I will group again the ring on a new group with layer mask, and I will take the rectangular mask key tool and just delete that part. So it's basically the on and the off side. Just made a new copy on top, and right now we'll make the basic knob. So we'll start with a black circle. We put this gray color on it. Just follow along here, we'll add a stroke with a gradient mode, fill type. Increase the size, hold shift and put it on the zero mark, 0 degrees. Put the blending mode on soft light and reduce the opacity. Add a gradient overlay with bright, a little brighter gray bluish on top. I made a new gradient by that because I will need it. Now this is the inner knob. Just Ctrl J again, hold Ctrl T, scale. I'll make another extra layer, just the outside stroke. We'll play with the blending modes here, we'll leave it on screen. Or maybe soft light, yeah, better. I'm reversing the inner gradient. So now we will create the pointer, which is basically a polygonal tool there with three sides with fill and no stroke on shape mode, and here on the gear icon these settings here, just so it's smooth. I will center my mouse and just hold shift and create the pointer. We can see it was a little off there. I had to align it myself. Now I'm just copying the layer style of the ring top. Double clicking there, remove the gradient overlay and just use a color overlay with the same glow color of the inner ring. Now on the group with the ring top, I will add another group layer style this time, just an outer glow. Now I'm tweaking a little bit the pointer glow there, so it's basically like turned on. Now I'm just taking a look. I think the off is a little bit strong, so I reduce the opacity up there of that layer. Control clicking the layer selects the layer, and I'm just using a color overlay on the inner part of the knob. You can make it white, you can make it dark. I think here just needed a little bit white or a soft blue. To just distinguish it a little bit more, to make it stand out a little more. So basically this was it, this was the knob part. Let's continue by adding text and a logo. All right. will first group all these knob objects, and I will take the text tool, the T, just click in here. I'm typing my text, my imaginary product name, which will be called Even More, inspired by Evenant. I'm choosing the font, a font that I like, tweaking the color, going into the settings, changing the scaling of the text, Control T to scale it down a little bit. Now I'll take the shape, the circle shape, and create a little circle there, like it's more like a logo and not just text. And I will choose some colors by double clicking on the layer thumbnail, brings up the color. I'm color picking the knobs blue color to make it have a little bit of harmony with the knob. Okay, and here I will type iMount, like it's the property for the effect, scaling it down. Just grouping the logo there, the product name, scaling it down, it was a little bit big. Zooming out really helps you see some small differences. Alright, and now I bring the Evenant logo. I will rotate it 90 degrees by holding shift. I will place it on top of the handle on the bottom there. Double clicking on the right side of the layer to bring up the effects. I'll put a little gradient to shade it a little bit like realistically, like it's sitting there. I have left a highlight on the bottom there, if you can see it. And now I will double click again to add some outer bevel. Resetting to default here, choosing down. Choose outer bevel, acts a little embossed on the handle, size on 0, tweaking a little bit the opacity, and that was it. And now tweaking some details, we'll make the background a little darker, it was a little washed out. Go to the base layer, color overlay. Just increase that a little bit, reduce the outer ring of the knob, and slight adjustments here on the knob itself, on the inner part. I will make it a tad darker. Okay, now it's time to add some fine details, tweak a little bit here and there. And I will start by making a new empty layer. I will name it Highlights and take the ellipse marquee tool, make a selection like this, go to select, modify and feather to soften the selection, and go into the edit fill with white. We will create a little nice highlight. I'm deselecting there and taking the smudge tool with a soft round brush, strength of 50, and just smudge the edges a little bit. I will copy this layer, Control J, to create a really hot spot in the middle and reducing the opacity of the bottom one. I will merge this layer now, center them, and duplicate the layer and put it on the bottom too. I will put them on a group to stay organized. All right, and now I will add some shadows from the handles going to the base. This will make it much more 3D-like and realistic. Make a new empty layer. Call it shadows. Take the brush tool with a soft round brush, about 35 size, a black color. Just hold shift and drag to make the brush. We'll take now the eraser with a little bit hard brush to make them a little bit more realistic and interesting, rather than just flat, blurry brushes. I'm deleting the corners and a little bit inwards, so it's much more realistic and much nicer this way. We delete a little bit here and there. I will reduce the opacity a little bit. Going to the top layer of the handle now, of the gradient overlay that we made before. And I will create a new point. And I will make it much more brighter on the top. And right now, this is very cool, much nicer. It has intense highlights and looks much cooler. I will copy the layer style and paste it on the left one as well. Much more nicer this way. Now, going again into the top layer of the handle overlay, increasing the dirt pattern. Just some customizing here to taste. Okay, now guys, we will finalize this little GUI here. We'll make a background. Take the gradient tool on radial gradient mode. Invert this gradient. So it's a little bit like vignette effect. Reduce the opacity. Now we will create like a showcasing image, product showcasing. Now we'll create a new layer and create some shadows, like the GUI lives there and drops the shadows on top of the background. Doing the same trick and taking the eraser again, like we did on the shadows from the handles. Go now to the fade eraser. We will fade this a little bit so it reduces the opacity, and this way we can create many layers of shadows. Removing the hardness now. Control and Z is the undo, in case we make mistakes. Now going into the gradient overlay that we made, going to image adjustments, hue saturation, to make it a tad bluer. All right, let's see what's more. I'm adding another layer of gradients into the base on color dodge mode with black and white color, and I will decrease the opacity of the gradient so the pattern overlay shows a bit more through. All right, I'm checking for any final adjustments. I'm adding some shadow from the inner knob now. It will make much more difference. I will make a little bit bluer color rather than just black. I'm duplicating the shadow with a plus icon, which is only on the newer versions of Photoshop, CC and above. Okay, and a little final detail on the base. I will use a stroke on inside mode, which will be the final detail of this small GUI, our little GUI here. Of course, there is always room for improvement and changes, but we will end this here because it's already a big tutorial. And with this video to introduction to GUI design, I hope I helped you learn some stuff with this video. If your dream is to become a GUI designer, this is a good start for you. And let's hope for more future videos. Who knows? Let's see. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. And see you on the next one. Take care. Bye bye.